world for December 1936. Around the country, there are lines again, but not for soup anymore. This time, it's for jobs aplenty as President Roosevelt fulfills his promise of a new deal for all Americans. Meanwhile, Wallace Simpson, that American gal who changed the course of British history by capturing the heart of a king, was spotted disembarking at the Brooklyn Pier, prompting speculation. Is it a New York wedding for these royal lovebirds? In entertainment news, Broadway star William Gillette is now recuperating in his Connecticut mansion after that near-fatal shooting on stage at the Palace Theater just 2 weeks ago. We hear that movie stars galore, including Clark Gable and the glamorous Myrna Loy, have been visiting the great actor in Connecticut, hoping to speed his recovery. For now, we wish him well and look forward to hearing again his famous cry, Watson, the King's Afoot.
Quite a stretch.
Be quiet.
you made me a Christmas present. I just love your Christmas presents. Last year, she made me her famous peach preserves. I was doubled with joy for 3 days.
Merry Christmas. This is for you.
Oh, thank you. It's beautiful.
This house is amazing. It must have cost the earth.
Oh, you know, Willie, it's never by halves.
Well, when did you move in?
About 3 months ago now.
And how's he feeling?
Well, he frightened me to death getting shot like that. And now he thinks he's going to catch the culprit all by himself. I say to him, Willie, you are not a policeman. But he locks himself up for hours in his laboratory.
You have a laboratory?
My dear, this house has everything. Oh, watch this.
Good Lord!
That's one of his favorites, along with his miniature railroad, the electric snow shovel, and the exploding monkey. Oh, that'll be mad and feeling. I'll be right back.
You holding up all right?
I think so.
Oh, you'll be fine. Just trust me.
Right.
Good.
You sure?
Oh, absolutely. I want to see the look on their face when we tell them the news. They'll say, what?
What? Greetings and salutations.
What country friends is this?
It is Illyria, lady.
My brother, he is in Elysium. Perchance he is not drowned. What think you, sailor?
It is perchance that you yourself were saved. Merry Christmas. Here's to the rebels. They shall be non-stop and very drunken. Can you believe that we've been on vacation for a mere 2 weeks and already I've missed you terribly?
Oh, thank you, Felix.
Not you, idiot. Aggie! I've been in love with her since I was... Uh-oh. There's my wife.
Keep talking, darling. It'll sound so wonderful when it's repeated back in court. Oh.
How was your time off?
Luxurious. We went to a spa. Felix hated it.
There was nothing to eat or drink, and we had to do some bizarre Buddhist exercise.
It was called yoga.
I thought that was the white pudding stuff.
No, that was yogurt.
It had the texture of bone marrow. It was like spoiled milk. It'll never catch on.
I just can't get over this place, can you?
He said it was something, but I had no idea.
Well, why would he build a castle on the Connecticut River?
Why does Gillette do anything? The man is insane.
But I thought he was your best friend.
And I repeat, the man is insane.
Builds an awfully nice house, though. Be excellent for a murder.
Why a murder?
Well, it's isolated. There are tons of rooms to hide the body, and it's on a river, so you can drown people. What more do you want? An axe?
He has one.
Two.
Three.
As well as two broadswords, a garrote, and a brace of pistols. Why, if Connecticut is ever attacked by Rhode Island, this house will be the first line of defense.
Ah! And the snow fell gently upon the stable. And in front of the stable, a manger of wood. And in that manger lay a boy child.
And his name was Sherlock Holmes.
Oh, William.
Aggie, dear.
Wait, Rory.
Matt, darling.
How is your arm? Are you in pain?
Oh, no. It's much better. Thank you for asking. Oh, Simon. So good to see you.
Very good to see you, sir.
I see that you have all arrived despite the inclement weather and wind.
It is getting pretty dicey out there.
Oh, yes, blow winds, eh? And crack at the cheeks.
Spout till you have drenched our steeples, drowned the cocks.
Ah, and at that, the morning cock crew loud.
But at the sound of it, shrunk in haste away. The knave turns fool that runs away.
Help! Where is my fool? I think the world has fallen asleep.
To sleep
her chance to dream.
Ah, to sleep. No more.
Fault. You repeated sleep. Game, set, match to Felix.
My God, I love you.
Of course you do.
Ha! Felix, you scoundrel. Were you making fun of me down here? More! Well, I do have proof, you know.
Why would he build a castle on the Connecticut River?
Why does Jill do anything? The man is insane.
But I thought he was your best friend.
And I repeat, the man is insane.
My God, what was that? It's my latest microphones installed here and also back here. And I can turn them on and off at all the light switches.
Well, how do you play it back?
Ah, good question. With this, it's called a remote control. First presented to the Academy of Science in 1903. Under development ever since. It sends signals through the air without any wires. Even the military is starting to use them now.
You're amazing.
Hello, my darlings. I brought some bubbly so we can really celebrate.
Now we're talking.
Oh, here, let me help you with that. It looks awfully heavy.
Oh, my darling boy. He looks after me, unlike some children I know who shall remain unnamed.
An ill-favored thing, sir, but she's mine own.
Oh, stop blabbering, Willie. He can be so irritating, especially since he got shot. He's so proud. By the way, where's Barnes? I haven't seen him anywhere. Who's Barnes? He's our butler. We don't have a butler.
Yes, well, I'm afraid I gave him the night off.
What?
Yes, I mean, it is Christmas Eve, and besides, we're all family here.
Willie, how could you? With your bad arm, you can't even help me.
Oh, nonsense. Look, I'm fine. I've been meaning to do this for 2 days now. Here. Frame that.
We'll call it, Farewell to Arms.
I suppose there's been no progress in finding the man who shot you?
Yes. Well, the police have almost given up. But I believe that I have found something.
What?
Do you remember the note that was left at the stage door the night of the shooting?
The stage door?
I do. Old Nazi said that the envelope was addressed to you, but the note was blank.
Exactly. And so the police lost interest in it. But I have been subjecting it to some tests of my own upstairs in my laboratory. In the end, it was a matter of trial and error. It's hard to know which chemicals to use. In the end, I added some sodium carbonate in with a solution of alcohol. So it isn't just the alcohol that's doing it, but also the chemical causes a reaction.
Oh my gosh!
Look!
Dear Mr. Holmes, dang, you're dead.
They were trying to kill you.
But wait, there's more. HVIII135, it's like a cipher.
Maybe it's a German code, you know, with Hitler and all.
Possibly. Or on the other hand. Aggie, could you hand me that volume of Shakespeare back on the table? You know, most people don't know this. But when Sherlock Holmes says, "The game's afoot," in The Adventure of the Abbey Grange, he's actually quoting Shakespeare.
Which play?
HVIII. Henry VIII.
That's a wonderful guess, Simon, but it's wrong.
Henry V.
Of course.
once more into the breach, dear friend, once more, or else close up the wall with our wounded dead.
I see you stand like greyhounds in the slips, straining upon the start. The game's afoot!
So, HV is Henry V.
And I-135 is... Act 3, Scene 1, Line 35. At the marking.
The game's afoot! Wow!
And it was left for you on the stage door? That's rather creepy.
What does it mean?
It means whoever wrote that note is seriously crazy.
There's something more, isn't there? Let me see that. There's a watermark.
What's a watermark?
Well, it's an impression that's left in the paper at its manufacturing.
It's a sort of an advertisement. Hotels use it, and businesses.
Oh, no.
What?
Where's it from?
The Palace Theater.
Oh, no.
I'm not understanding this.
It means that whoever wrote the note had access to our stationery. It means they work at our theater.
Could have been someone on the stage crew.
Or a director.
Or an actor.
Well, you've certainly made it a jolly Christmas, Willie.
Oh, nonsense. We shouldn't jump to any conclusion. Why, someone could have swiped the paper.
And in which case, no one here is involved at all.
And it is like a beehive backstage. Yeah.
True.
Ladies and gentlemen, your glasses, your glasses. To the swiper! Cheers!
Cheers!
Merry Christmas to us. To us.
Well, while we have the drinks out and feeling jolly and all, I'd like to make an announcement if I may.
Well,
go on!
Aggie and I are married!
What?
What?
You mean engaged?
No, married 4 weeks ago.
Oh, congratulations!
That's great.
He tells me nothing. My son tells me nothing at all.
Well, I know we were going to tell you after the run, but then the shooting happened.
Oh, it's marvelous. Isn't it wonderful?
Here? Oh, yes, absolutely.
And you're so brave for getting married again after what happened last time.
Mother.
Well, she is. I mean, her husband died on their honeymoon, didn't he? That's what I heard.
Mother, for heaven's sake.
Well, yes, he did die, Mrs. Gillette, and... I don't mind talking about it. In fact, talking about it makes it more bearable.
There, are you satisfied? Now tell us what happened. I want to know everything.
Well, there really isn't much to tell. Hugo and I, that was my husband, we were married just over a year ago when we went to Killington in Vermont to ski for our honeymoon.
Did you really? I hear that's very expensive.
Her husband was quite well off.
That's what I heard. They say he was loaded. One of the richest men in the entire country.
That's it. I give up.
Oh, Willie, stop it. You know how I hate it when people beat around the bush. Take you and Penelope. You were married. She died, you miss her, and there's an end to it. And it makes you feel better when you talk about it, doesn't it?
Yes, it does.
Thank you. Go on, my dear. Spill the beans.
Well, my husband was an excellent skier, and he decided to try the Black Diamond Slope, which was the most dangerous one at the resort. And he got all dressed in his jacket and his goggles, and the attendant tightened his boots and his gloves, and Hugo set off down that hill as happy as I'd ever seen him. And then...
Yes?
Well, the strap on his boot just broke. Oh, he was coming down the hill, and
not for long. She had a good sense to wear me that night. We've been best friends for ages, and I was in a play in New York at the time.
And he dropped everything and arrived the next day. He was such a great comfort.
And the rest is history. How romantic.
In a lugubrious sort of way.
Don't you start. Martha's right. You have to face up to life. No matter what it throws at you, how difficult it can get, you just have to say to hell with the bastards and go on living.
That's my girl. Now let's cheer things up with a little music, shall we?
To the happy couple.
The happy couple. Pulling up to the dock at this very moment. There's someone else.
Who is it?
Yes.
Oh, Lily. Is she in the show?
No, not in the show, but in show business.
Do we know her?
Well, you certainly know her. I smell trouble.
Oh, Lily. Stop being coy. I swear the man could drive St. Joan to drink. Just tell us who it is.
It's Daria Chicks.
No!
She's awful.
She's worse than that.
I met her at a party once, and she completely snubbed me.
She gave me the worst review I've ever had in my life. I was in a costume drama with Joan Crawford, no less. And she said, the radiant Miss Crawford came on to the clicking of high heels, followed by a lump of roast beef.
She said I played Hamlet's mother, looking like a worried hamster.
I was in a play last year and appeared in a swimsuit. She wrote, Simon Bright's audacity in the role was largely an excess of his equipment.
Well, she is clever, at least. She's a spiteful, gossip-mongering harridan witch. And you owe us all an explanation.
Here, here.
Well, fine.
She's writing a piece on me for Vanity Fair. And she asked if she could come to one of our weekends. Look, like it or not, Daria Chase is the most influential columnist in the country.
Why?
This profile on me? It'll give us more free publicity than if I shot Lincoln!
Alright, so, as a favor to me, I suggest you at least be civil to Miss Chase. And get off your fannies and go down to the dock and meet her! Thank you!
And sit, ungrateful guest, shuffling feet.
You're up to something, aren't you? You didn't tell me?
I couldn't. I didn't have the courage.
Courage?
I didn't want you to think less of me.
Oh, well, Simon is a fine fellow.
He's more than that.
I know. I'm sorry. Look, what I meant was...
I know what you mean. He's ordinary. He's nice. He's easy to please. Well, he is those things, and he's in love with me.
Yes, but are you in love with him?
Kind, and when I needed him, he was there in an instant.
Oh, yes, of course he was.
I know. I know that you did, and I was too much a fool not to take you up on it. I had this notion that I was being loyal to my wife's memory.
It's been 10 years since your wife died.
Yes, I know.
Oh, William.
Oh, Aggie, look, you're gonna be fine. The best man won, I'm sure of it. Besides, I mean, look at me. I'm old enough to be your slightly older brother.
Thanks. Thanks a million. It's just that I puppet, you felt something. You treat everything as a joke. Even this horrible attempt at your life.
No, not as a joke, but as a game. A game is a different thing entirely. Look, I mean, we have chosen this mad life of ours, and we'd be insane not to accept it for anything other than what it is. Do I go to an office to work? No. Do I wear a tie to work? Oh, thank God, no. Look. We're actors. We put on silly costumes and we wear noses made of putty, for God's sake. We don't want to be grown-ups. You know what? We're all just Peter Pans, right? And a good thing it is, too. Because I don't want to give up all the fun because I've reached some magical age of regret. But that's what they want us to do, you know. All those gray, faceless actors out there. But I won't do it. Look, I won't do it. I don't treat life as a joke. I treat it as the most glorious game ever invented. Love and heartbreak. It's a game. Life and death. It's the most glorious game, the biggest adventure. You know, Shakespeare, he got it right on the nose. Richard III, charging into battle against overwhelming odds, and what does he cry? It's all a game, and if I die, I die. So let them praise me, or hate me, or even shoot at me. But at the end of it all, I will have lived, even just for a moment. And if you think that you need Simon to live like that, then by all means, take him. Don't hesitate for a second. I will miss you terribly.
Gillette, guess who's here? It's our old friend, Daria Chase.
Merry Christmas! Oh, William, my dear, sweet, wonderful man. How's your arm? Your heart? Your soul? Oh, after that ghastly shooting, I thought I'd never see you again. That, or I'd find you limping like a broken line into your fine water and all.
And yet, here I am, right as rain and twice as healthy. Daria, you look magnificent.
Oh, please stop. I simply grabbed what was ever hanging in my sad little closet as I bounded out of New York City for the countryside on Christmas Eve. Oh, my. Just smell the air out here. I haven't smelled air like this since I was a young girl, growing up in Kansas, or wherever it was with those divine little cows and things. How lucky you all are.
famous painting in the grass, but with our clothes on.
Feelings, dear. How are you?
Oh, not as well as you, obviously.
Stop. My beauty is superficial, and yours is on the inside. Madge! We go back a ways, don't we, dear? I remember when I first came to New York City as a youngster. How I looked up to you with all your years of experience.
And yet my friends and I called you mother.
Oh, stop, that's impossible. You didn't have any friends.
I had Felix.
Well, didn't everyone?
Mother! I'm Daria! Let me introduce you to the rest of the clan. Daria Chase, my mother, Martha Gillette.
We've met before, very briefly, at a party. And I do read your column. In fact, I keep it right beside my bed in case I can't get to sleep at night.
What a witty thing to say. So unexpected.
Daria, it's nice to see you.
Simon, you are looking well.
As are you.
Wait, I didn't know that you two knew.
Of course we do. We met at Killington at the big weekend. I was there for the skiing and those divine parties. And then after I left, your husband had that ghastly accident, didn't he? Oh, I was so upset. If I had stayed, I would have had one of the biggest scoops of the entire year. Poor you.
I bet you didn't know that they're married now.
For 4 weeks.
4 weeks, 2 days, and 6 hours. I'm especially proud of 6 hours. Shows I can really stick to it.
The truth is, I do know about it. And I plan to put it in my column on Monday morning. I mean, just look at the two of you. Your headline news. 1 minute, you're character actors. And the next minute, you have inherited half of the Pacific Northwest.
What? What do you mean?
What do I mean? You just married the married widow of Manhattan, for Pete's sake.
I'm sorry, you got it wrong. Cuba didn't leave or anything.
Excuse me, but I am a reporter, and when I found the records on your marriage, I happened to see Hugo's last will and testament. He left you everything, didn't he? All of his millions.
Yes, he did.
Listen, Pete!
Why didn't you tell us?
I don't know. I didn't want anyone to change a relationship with me. They would think differently of me. You know they would.
Does this mean you're rich? Very rich? I'm rich! I'm rich! I'm rich! I'm rich! I'm rich! How do you do? I'm rich? You ain't touched me. You just made my day!
I must say, this cast of yours gives me endless things to write about. It's like I invented you, just for the purpose.
We would rather you wrote about the plays and not about us.
Oh, nonsense. Of course you would. Everybody wants publicity. It's magic. It's changing the world. Look at me. I'm a sorceress. With the wave of the pen, I can make you a star. Poof. Publicity equals fame. And fame equals fortune. It's just like a drug that never stops. And I must say, you all have been hogging the limelight quite beautifully, haven't you? First, the shooting, which in itself must have doubled my readership. Then the inheritance. And now the murder.
Murder?
What? Murder?
Hey, you mean the shooting?
No, the murder. Don't tell me that you don't know what. Do you know about it?
Yes, I'm afraid that I do, actually. I was going to tell everyone after dinner.
Oops.
Who was murdered?
Nobs.
Stage doorman Nobs?
Yes. I'm afraid so. The police asked me to identify the body this morning. Apparently, it happened sometime late last night.
I was there.
Excuse me.
But there's no play out at the moment.
I was doing background work on my article.
Well, did you see Noggs there?
I did when I went in, but he was murdered apparently when I was on the inside.
But who would murder him? I mean, poor Noggsy.
Maybe he saw something related to the shooting, or overheard someone talking about it.
Could it have been an accident?
Yeah, natural causes, like a heart attack.
Yes, that would be very comforting. Except that his throat was slit from ear to ear with a razor blade.
There's a storm brewing.
I have a feeling it's going to get quite nasty out there before it's over.
Oh, nonsense. It's Christmas Eve and it's time for dinner. Let's go, everybody. Right this way. No, Portia, stop it!
Oh, Felix, dear. Felix, will you take me in? I'm like the maiden aunt of the family, all sad and lonely.
Of course. Sorry.
Oh, Aggie, darling, will you take me in? I'm with the bachelor and uncle of the family, all full of myself and noisy.
Stop it, she'll hear you.
Let's leave the door open, shall we? So we can hear some music through dinner.
Are we going through with it?
Absolutely.